Amen. Well, thank you for allowing us to be with you here in worship this evening. Now, here's a new song that talks about the great joy of heaven.
Can you just imagine what that day will be like when all God's people worship the King of Kings? The glorious sound and the heavenly light. Just thinking about home makes me want to sing. Thinking about home makes me want to sing.
Hallelujah, He is risen. Hallelujah, He is alive. And forever in majesty He reigns. Hallelujah, He is risen. Unto Him we testify. And forever.
Recreation was founded in 1976 and since then has provided thousands of concerts all across America. Our main service ministry is to the hospitalized veterans nationwide, a service Recreation has provided for more than 25 years exclusively.
That service is outlined in the blue programs we gave to you earlier. If you haven't already read through them, please take them home with you. They contain a great deal of information about Recreation's history.
Tonight, we're celebrating joy, or rather the potential joy we have in God's promise of a triumphant and vibrant life.
We'll worship and pray and study with many styles of music. Traditional hymns, praise and worship, children's songs, and dramatic pieces. And we want you to participate. Feel free to sing along, applaud, lift your hands, shout amen if you want to, however the Spirit may lead you.
Our program Vivid is designed with certain visual elements, specific colors, each representing a different aspect of God's great love.
John 10:10 tells us that Jesus came to earth to bring about life and to bring it more abundantly. And that's what we'll seek here this evening, a life that is thriving, alive, a life that is vivid.
Blue is the stream to the river.
Continue our brilliant celebration of gold. You may recognize some of these old-time favorites, so feel free to sing along.
Amen. Wow, you sounded great. Heaven is more than a concept, more than a whim. It is a divine promise and a pledge of love. We try to hold to that promise every day. Just recently, my grandfather passed away, and it was one of the very first times in my life that I lost someone close to me. It was hard, and I struggled, but my family and I, we drew on our faith, and I realized that the promises that God makes to me are the same promises that he made to Grandpa and to all of us. And I knew that everything was okay. If you've recently lost someone, you too can cling to that promise of God, that eternal promise of heaven.
I can just see them walking on the shores of heaven. They're praising the Lord, watching the tide roll in. Friends that have gone on, oh, how I miss you so. And somehow I know if you could, you'd let me know that you're doing fine and it doesn't hurt.
Revelation 22, verse 1. Then the angel showed me the river of the water of life flowing from the throne of God.
Shall we gather at the river where bright angels' feet have trod, with its crystal tide forever flowing from the throne of God? Yes, we'll gather at the river, the beautiful, beautiful river. Gather with the saints at the river that flows from the throne of God. Throne of God, God, I'll lay down my burden down by the riverside, down by the riverside, down by
Jesus Christ. a divine reminder of God's river of revival and refreshment. Guys?
In the Holy Book we read of John the Baptist, how Moses led God's children out of Egypt's land, how Jesus fed the multitude with the loaves and fishes, how he touched and healed the man with the withered hand. Now I don't mean to take one thing from all these stories. They are miracles from God, and that's a fact. But God's power is still the same, so those who call upon his name, speak the word and watch the sea roll back. He'll be a cool drink of water in the desert. When you're hungry, he'll rain manna from the sky. He'll be your strength when you're weary from the battle. For your need, he will send you great supply. So many times in my hour of desperation, I've gone to Jesus and he's heard my earnest plea. You'll see it makes good sense to give the Lord just a little chance, and you'll see how much a friend he can be.
Remember how he saved old Daniel from the lions, and saved the Hebrew children from the flaming fire. He spoke about that shining city on Mount Zion, said, follow me and I'll give to you your heart's desire.
If folks today would only heed the words of Jesus, and Matthew 21 says, ask and you'll receive. He'll make your heart to sing and dance if you just give him a little chance, and you'll see how much a friend he can be.
He'll be a cool drink of water in the desert. When you're hungry, he'll rain manna from the sky. He'll be your strength when you're weary from the battle. For your need, he will send a great supply.
So many times in my hour of desperation, I've gone to Jesus and he's heard my earnest plea.
You can see it makes good sense to give the Lord this little chance, and you'll see how much a friend he can be. He'll be a cool drink of water in the desert. When you're hungry, he'll rain manna from the sky. He'll be your strength when you're weary from the battle. For your need, he will send a great supply.
So many times in my hour of desperation, I've come to Jesus and he's heard my earnest plea.
You can see it makes good sense to give the Lord just a little chance, and you'll see how much a friend he can be. Well, you can see it makes good sense to give the Lord just a little chance, and you'll see how much a friend he can be.
Ephesians 1:7, in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins in accordance with the riches of God's grace.
I was walking in the country on a Sunday afternoon when I saw a church around the bend ahead. It was neatly kept and spotless, white with flowers in the yard, and I noticed that the door was painted red. It was such a pretty picture, but the focus was the door, for it made me want to take a closer look. So I stepped inside and noticed on a table near at hand a carefully marked passage in a book. It was a holy Bible, Hebrews 9 verse 22, and I recognized the promise that it said, that forgiveness is in Jesus through the shedding of his blood. I understand now why the door was red.
Thank you. has to be in red.
Never lose. It will never lose.
message. Now, before we continue with the music, we would like you to meet the members of Recreation's 33rd edition. And this year, we have something a little special in our group in that we have two sets of siblings. Can you find them? Hello, my name is Sarah Buck. I'm from Freehold, New Jersey. This is my third year in the group, and I sing soprano.
Hi, my name is Candace Quinn. I'm from Mount Joy, Pennsylvania, and I also sing soprano.
Hello, my name is Billy Habecker. I'm from Milton, Pennsylvania. I'm a graduate of Penn State University, and I sing tenor.
Hello, I'm Laura McLaughlin. I'm also from Milton, Pennsylvania, and I sing soprano.
Hello, my name is Andy Reich. I'm from Montana, Pennsylvania. I sing high tenor and serve as Recreation's road manager.
Hi there, my name is Jen. I'm from Lyttis, Pennsylvania. I sing alto as well as serve as Recreation's tour manager.
And we're the brothers. My name is Randy Robbins, and I'm from Montana, Pennsylvania, and I sing bass.
And hi, my name's Austin Robbins. I'm from Montana, too, and I sing baritone.
And we are sister and brother. Hi there, my name is Abigail Diener. I am from Lancaster, Pennsylvania, and I sing alto.
And hello, my name's Adam Diener. I'm also from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. I sing lead tenor and serve as Recreation's assistant vocal teacher. Now, while you see the 10 of us up front, there's one more in our group who is very important to what we do. She's in the back, and we'd like you to meet her now. From Windham, Ohio, please make welcome our sound engineer, Sarah Dougherty.
Green, the color of life. A good garden needs nurturing and care. Only then can it grow and bloom and provide beauty and comfort. We too need a special care, a care that only Jesus can provide.
Isaiah 58:11. The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs and will strengthen you. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail.
Once we've grown and accepted God's care in our daily lives, we have a responsibility to share His support with others. Our testimony. Our sowing seeds can have a profound effect on someone else's garden, offering them hope, comfort, guidance. I know when things have been difficult in my life, it's been helpful to have friends, brothers and sisters who will encourage and console and, yes, even convict me when I need it. Now, we all have the tendency to say, it's too hard, things will never get better, why try? But Psalm 37 says to trust God, to do good things, to delight yourself in the Lord. And when we do this, we'll be too busy reaping His joy to focus on the negative. You can be an emotional missionary, offering a kind word, a bright smile, or even a song. And here's a song that we think can uplift even the most downtrodden spirit.
Operator, give me information. Information, give me long distance. Long distance.
Give real practical service to those in need, to show the world Christ's love and His hope.
I used to pray hard for a miracle to end all the suffering I see. In this sacred moment, my eyes have been opened. Maybe it starts here with me. Let's bring down the walls of complacency. Start moving with mercy and faith. Be the hands of God, touching the burning with loving love wide as the sky. Be the heart of grace, pleading forgiveness with tender compassion. Be feed the 5,000, to care for the hungry we see. You don't have to walk on the water to get to somebody in need. There's no good excuse not to let him use the miracle.
Ladies and gentlemen, sing along with some of your favorite songs from Sunday school. Repeat after Laura. Here we go.
one.
Everybody sing along.
Violet is widely considered the liturgical color of Easter, representing the resurrection, the power of the stone rolled away, the promise of an empty tomb. But before that miracle, that gift, there was a selfless, decided, dramatic sacrifice. 1 John 2:2, he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not only for ours, but also for the sins of the whole world. Amen. Well, we've come full circle now, back to the promise of heaven. But now, there is a distinct difference. Because of Jesus' sacrifice, we can approach that promise with a purity and a confidence. Nothing remains now but the pure white of His light, His love in our hearts.
God loves you, and you can walk with Him every day in the grand miracle that is His creation, and in your relationships and the wonder of this world. If that joy, that assurance, seems too far away, it's not. But sometimes we need help to claim it and live in it. If you want to live a life that's vivid, full in all the glory, victory, and peace that God has for you, then seek out the leadership of your local church. But don't walk through life without the knowledge that God is on your side.
And as we set to leave these walls of sanctuary, take these colors and let them be a reminder daily, moment by moment, of Jesus and His wonderful, wonderful gift of life.
Revelation 3:5 says, "All who are victorious will be clothed in white. I will never erase their names from the book of life, but will announce before my Father and His angels that they are mine." Amen.
Sing along.